गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, दिस इज कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ चैप्टर 9, ऑस्ट्रेलिया लोकेशन पॉलिटिकल डिविजन्स एंड फिजिकल फीचर्स. सो इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू फ्रॉम फिजिकल फीचर्स ऑफ ऑस्ट्रेलिया. ऑस्ट्रेलिया हैज अ ह्यूज वैरायटी ऑफ फिजिकल फीचर्स, बट इट डजंट हैव हाई माउंटेन्स, large rivers and deep valleys. The physical features of Australia can be divided into 4 divisions. Those are Eastern Highlands, the Central Lowlands, the Western Plateau and the Coastal Plains. In page 122, the divisions are given clearly. So this green part is your coastal plains. The pink portion is Western Plateau, the yellow portion is Central Lowlands, and the grey portion, this part, is Eastern Highlands. So first let us start with the Eastern Highlands. The Eastern Highlands, the Eastern Highlands start from Cape York in Queensland to Victoria, and it continued till Bass Strait. Now, the Eastern Highlands include the Great Dividing Range and the Great Barrier Reef. The Great Dividing Range. First, let me tell you why it is called Great Dividing Range. Because of two reasons. One, because it was prohibited for the early settlers to go in Great Dividing Range, and the second reason is that they are so called because their slopes divide the water flow of the rivers of this region. Because of these two reasons, it is known as Great Dividing Range. Next is, what do you mean by weathering and erosion? Weathering is the breaking down or dissolving of rocks and minerals on Earth's surface. Now, once the rocks has been broken down, a process called erosion transport the bit of rocks and minerals away. So, earlier the Great Dividing Range consisted of folded rocks. Now, if you want to see how folded rocks look, you can refer to Google. But after, when the Great Dividing Range has undergone weathering and erosion, their surface now looks more like a plateau. Here you can see in this figure, this portion looks more like a plateau and its sloping is towards the Pacific Ocean. This blue color is Pacific Ocean. So the sloping is towards the Pacific Ocean. It consists of many mountain ranges. Mount Kosciuszko, which is in South Wales, is the highest peak in Australia. Then, in New South Wales and in northeast of Victoria, many peaks are covered and are known for winter sports. Let me show you where is New South Wales. So here you can see New South Wales and Victoria. This part is completely covered with snow and are known for winter sports. In South Wales, the Great Dividing Range is known as Blue Mountains. So this portion is known as Blue Mountains. In Victoria state, they are called Australian Alps. A number of rivers like River Murray and River Darling originate from these mountains, and these river waters are used for electricity. Next is the Great Barrier Reef. Great Barrier Reef, you can see it's here, the Great Barrier Reef. This portion is Great Barrier Reef. So the Great Barrier Reef of Australia is the largest coral reef in the world. It is composed of over 3,000 individual reefs and 900 islands. It stretches over 1,900 meters along the northeast coast of Australia. So this side is north and here is east. So it stretches over northeast part of Australia. Now, coral reef is formed by tiny sea creatures called coral polypus. Coral polypus are tiny marine animals which live in mud-free, shallow, warm, salty water. They secrete calcium carbonate, which is a white substance which accumulates into a ridge-like structure formed below the sea level after their death. And these structures are in many shapes and sizes. Now, coral, they are of pink, red and white color. Although it is a significant tourist attraction, but it is very risky and dangerous for ships. Human activities like mining is prohibited in this area because it can cause damage to the reef and its aquatic life. Next is the central lowlands. The central lowlands extend from Encounter Bay in the south to Gulf of Carpentaria in the north. Central lowlands is this part. This yellow color part is central lowlands. So the central lowlands extend from Encounter Bay in the south to the Gulf of Carpentaria in the north. So this whole part is central lowlands. These plains are divided into three parts: the Murray-Darling Basin, Lake Eyre Basin, and the Carpentarian Lowlands. The Murray-Darling Basin, this part, River Murray and Darling, this part is rich in agriculture area and it gets it ample of water supply from the rivers. Now, River Murray is the river and its tributary is Darling and Murrumbidgee. These are the tributaries. The Murray River Darling Basin, this part, is the most fertile region of Australia. These are the longest perennial rivers of Australia. And also these rivers, the Murray, River Murray and River Darling are snow-fed rivers which originate from Southern Alps. From here it is originating. Next is Lake Eyre Basin. Lake Eyre Basin, here you can see Lake Eyre Basin, this portion. The Lake Eyre Basin is the inland drainage, basin of Australia, which lies in the middle part of central lowlands. This basin lies 11 meters below the sea level. All the small rivers or streams that do not reach the ocean fall into Lake Eyre. It is the largest salt lake in the continent of Australia. Next is the Carpentarian Lowlands. So, the Carpentarian Lowlands, this part is Carpentarian Lowlands, this part. So, the Carpentarian Lowland, it lies in the north of Central Lowlands. Many small rivers originate from this region fall into the Gulf of Carpentaria. The names of those rivers are River Mitchell and River Flinders. It is world's largest artesian basin. Which basin? The Carpentarian Lowlands.